Now we'll look at if-else statements. And so public class, I'll do the same thing as last time, but this will be if-else fun. Static void main string args. And then I'll import java util dot scanner. Set up that scanner. Scanner in equals new scanner system in. Okay, so and we'll continue on with this idea of age. I don't know why I'm suddenly obsessed about age. Every example I do is about it. I must be hitting my midlife crisis. I do want a sports car, but it's been that way for a long time. So I don't know. But what we're going to do in this one is just decide whether the person is over the hill or under the hill. That's not right. That's the opposite, though. So that's what we'll decide. What is it? Before the hill? Over the hill? On the way up the hill? Maybe that's a better way of putting it. Okay, so we'll make that decision based on what they enter. So system.out.println. Again, how old are you? Question mark. I'll read that into age. I'm going through all this a little bit faster since hopefully we're picking this up. I'll get the next int, and then I'm going to make a decision. If, now the decision traditionally has been if you're 40 years old or older, you're over the hill, right? Isn't that what they say? And so I'm going to make that statement. I'm going to say if the age. Now, how do we do greater than? Well, we do the greater than symbol. And I guess 40 technically is over the hill when you turn 40. So we got to equal 40 as well. And so the way that we do that, if we want to do both, is to first put the greater than or less than sign and then an equal sign. So if age is greater than or equal, that's how we say that in Java, to 40, then we can print system.out.println, you're over the hill. All right. Now, shouldn't the hill move, by the way, with medical advances? I mean, we were living longer, right? So, anyway. So if that's the case, then it will print you're over the hill. Let's test it. How old are you? Well, I'm 39. It doesn't print anything. But if I say I am 45, then it will say you're over the hill. And if I say 40, then because of that equals sign in there, it should get that as well. So let's try it. Okay, and it tells me you're over the hill as well. Well, what about for everybody else? All right. If we have a situation in programming where it's one or the other, it's either this or it's that, then that lends itself really well to something we call an if-else statement. So the way that this works is we have our if statement for one condition, and then after that we can put an else. Okay, there can't be anything in between. That's a mistake sometimes beginning programmers make, as they put a system out.println high in there. It'll get an error saying that's an else without an if, because there's something in between. It's not attached to the if. But if right after we close that if statement, we begin an else statement, then the else will be attached to the if. And whatever this condition is, if it's the opposite, if it's anything else, then it will execute this statement. And that is, I don't know what, working your way up the hill. This is like a very pessimistic way of looking at things, right? You're almost there. I'm working my way there, so that's why I don't know what it is. I'm suddenly obsessed about age. I got to come up with some other examples. Okay, so now if we run this, Then if the age is 45, then it will print the you're over the hill statement. Otherwise, it'll if I say 39 now, it'll tell me working your way up the hill. Because this is a if else. It's either one door or the other. You can't go in both doors. The only way to do the option to go in both doors is to do two separate if statements. So I could do that. I could, instead of having an else, I could say if age is less than 40, and this program will work the same. And in some ways, from a programming perspective, this is a safer way of doing things because you protect yourself when you're dealing with something more complicated than an age. Because the problem with this is if it's anything else, in doing it the way we had it before. So if I go back to the else statement, if it's anything else other than this, then it's going to do this statement. So you just have to be a little bit cautious from that perspective. And sometimes it's better just to write a bunch of if statements rather than trying to do if-elses. But there are some situations like this where you're either over the hill or you're not. And so this is a good situation to use an if-else statement in. And that's another conditional statement, another operation that we have to be able to make a decision in Java. We can say, if it's this, then do this, else, do this other thing. Spencer out.